Let's look at the settings of the Morvis Launcher. To access the settings, simply click the gear symbol on the main screen of the launcher. The settings are divided into different subcategories. Let's start with the client instances. First, you enter the number of clients you want to run in your setup. For local setups running HMDs, 1 is a very good number. For clusters, a higher number than 1 is recommendable. Next, you can rename any of the client instances. Simply right-click a client, choose Rename, and give it a name. This way, you will never lose track of which client does what on a cave setup. As most caves run on a cluster system, the IP address drop-down determines on which target IP the Morvis client should start. All computers running the Mor3D service will be listed in this drop-down. To install the Morvis service and the client components, simply run the Morvis setup on the target computer and select Install Client Components. Next, for each client, you can select the output type. There is SteamVR, a quad buffer output for cave, an anaglyphic output for testing, geometry corrected output for caves with Vioso, and many more. Plus, there is 2 output modes for domes. I will now select the cave quad buffer mode for demonstration purposes. For the eye output, you can choose between rendering both eyes. You can choose to render only a left view or a right view. This is very useful for dual head setups running a non-Quadro or non-Fire Pro type graphics card. You can choose the target display. All detected displays will be available in the drop-down, so each projector has an identifier number. To find out the number, simply click the Identify button and all connected devices will display their matching identifiers. The resolution of the chosen target display is shown in the resolution field. You can choose a level of anti-aliasing for each client individually. We usually recommend GIST setting for 2, which already gives very nice and smooth graphics. The next option is about the client window. You can choose to give the window a certain position. Entering an X value will move the starting point of the window to the right from the upper left edge of your screen, and entering a Y value will move it down from the upper left point of your screen. Next, you can define a window size in case you only want to use a certain portion of your display area. Simply enter the width and the height in pixels. And lastly, for this section, the viewport shift allows to move the 3D content inside the client window, following the same principle like window position. Entering an X value will move it to the right, and a Y value will move it down. You can also enter negative values for moving to the left or up. Next up is the cave port. This port is used to synchronize all clients on the cave. All cave clients must communicate on the same port. Running 2 caves on the same network requires both cave clients to use unique ports. So cave 1 would run on this port and cave 2 on a different port. Each cave cluster must run exactly one master node. So my center wall would not be a master node, and my floor wall would neither be a master node. Next, we can define, of course, the screen position. Opening the screen position presents us with this dialog, allowing for a simple window layout. This way, we can tell this client to be a left wall. The center wall does not require any screen positioning. The floor requires screen positioning, so I'm opening the dialog and I rotate it to the correct layout. Also, I will, of course, put the anti-aliasing here too, because it's very nice. The client LAN area holds technical configurations. These are usually automatically configured. OpenGL port. This port defines the ports that the Morbis client listens on for OpenGL data sent by the Morbis hook and the host application. The VRPN port defines the port that the Morbis client listens on for tracking data by the VRPN translator. Now let's real quickly look at the SteamVR options. The SteamVR options are reduced to the pixel density setting. A higher number means a better image quality, but also more stress for your graphics card. The advanced movement selector allows to set the movement direction through your touchpad or the joystick of the VR controller. By default, it is disabled because new users often find it confusing, while advanced users don't want to miss that option. Choose for yourself. Thank you so much for watching this quick tutorial on the Morbis settings about the client instances.